Hey guys, Brandon here from Exotic Cars 19 Extras, and I got a request after all of my unboxings to do a whole collection video, and that's what I'm going to present to you guys today. So I'm going to try to briefly say what scale they are and where I got it if I remember to, and just kind of skim over this. This is not a just 118 scale collection. I have just a little bit of everything, as you guys can see. So I'll go ahead and go over all of these, and if I can find the links to these, I will put them in the description, because most of these are from Amazon. So if I can find the links to these, I will definitely put them in the description, so feel free to check that out. So we're going to go ahead and start off left over here. All of these are either 136 or 132 scale, I believe. All of these are like the ones where like you wind them back, they go forward, but they actually make really, really good scale models. So this is the Gumpert Apollo S. This is the 4GT Aston Martin V12 Vantage. We have a Porsche 911 GT3 RS, Nissan GTR, Bentley Continental. I don't know what to call this one, like the soft top convertible version, but anyway, Bentley Continental, Alfa Romeo 4C, and then a Scion FRS. We have a couple more of those scales here, and just to say about all these scales, or something to say about all these scales, they were either $7, like $6.99 online, or roughly $10 at like CVS or online. Some of these were actually about $6 or $7 at a CVS as well. So yeah, CVS actually carries some nice cars, believe it or not. Here on the same scale, we have a Lamborghini Gallardo Superleggera. I'm hoping it's focusing on the cars. I'm trying to look through the viewfinder or something. Anyway, Lamborghini Murcielago, Murcielago SV. We have the Aventador, Sesto Elemento, and the Veneno, all in the same scales. Sticking with those scales, we have the 136 or 132, whichever. Yellow Gallardo, orange Gallardo, and a red Gallardo first generation. I love these so much, I actually had three of the red ones and I gave two of them away. So now I have one, and I just painted a couple of the accenting there. But yeah, I love these things. I can't hold back buying them. Whenever I see them, I buy them. And most of the time they're red, so I had three at one point and that was kind of useless. So gave two away. Here's a big, I don't even know what scale, maybe that's like a 1.8, but it's a remote control Murcielago SV. Got that one from Costco. I don't really use it for a remote control car. It actually makes a really, really nice scale. The video's not really doing it justice, but it's very, very nice. We have a 124 scale Aventador. I believe that one was also from CVS or Walgreens or something like that. Right over here we have the, these are Maestos or whatever, the 118 scales. This is a Lamborghini Huracan, another Murcielago. We have the Gallardo Superleggera. And then up here, this one, I really like this one, not so much for its quality, but kind of like for its rarity, I guess you could say. It's kind of rare. This is the Pagani Zonda Cinque. I got this one on Amazon, 118 scale. I forgot the price, I'll definitely put the link in the description. But it was made by Motormax. Here's another 124 scale. This one I got from CVS as well. Just a Pagani Zonda F, I believe it's the F. Here, again, Motormax off Amazon. This is a Pagani Huayra. Forgot what I paid for this one. Actually, no. This one was from Costco for like a steal. It was like $18, but I have seen it on Amazon as well in different colors. I'll put all the colors in the link as well. Oh, 136 scale Audi R8. This one, as far as its detail and realistic, it's not the best, but you know, it kind of fits my other R8s. This one, I forgot who makes it, but it is another R8, whatever you call this, the GT3 class or whichever race editions. And then this I got from Amazon. This is a Maisto, what is it, the special edition Maisto Audi R8 GT edition. GT was 2012 with the little aerodynamic spoiler and all the downforce pieces there. This is my favorite R8 made. Like it a lot better than the newer ones as well. Okay. And up here, we have a 136 scale Mercedes SLS, followed by a 124 scale SLR, and then a 124 scale McLaren MP4-12C. The doors do not open on that one, unfortunately, but they do on this one. So yeah, it makes for a nice little piece. And then again, doors open on such a small scale, I like that. And then over here we have a Lotus Evora S GP edition made by Motormax. It's a 124 scale. I got this one because my neighbor has this car and he let me review it and drive it quite a few times for my other YouTube channel, just Exotic Cars 19 on YouTube. After driving this one forever, I looked and looked all over the internet and I finally found a scale model of it. Glad I got that one. And I'm going to try to look for another one so I could give that one to the owner of the car. Here's a 132 scale or 136 scale Exige. Very nice as well. Then we start getting over to some of my favorites, this whole column right here. We'll actually start at the bottom here. This is a Hot Wheels Elite. I think I got this one on Amazon as well. Hot Wheels Elite 509 GTO Ferrari, followed by a little LaFerrari there I got at like some grocery store, and then like Ferrari cologne box. I just figured to kind of suit that little square fairly well, but something might replace that. Here we have two Hot Wheels Elites as well. This is a 458 Speciale. They had it in red and yellow, but the yellow I thought was a little bit more rare with the stripes and the black accenting and all that. Here, and plus I was already going to get the red LaFerrari, so I wanted some contrasting. So here is the Hot Wheels Elite red LaFerrari. Makes for a nice piece with the two of them here. They kind of do each other well here. But so that's kind of like the Ferraris there. I have some more on the list I want to get. Here's a 118 scale Koenigsegg 1:1 made by Frontier. The doors do not open. This one is a very, very nice piece, limited to 300 models. This is 194 of 300, with a little certificate or like a little card there that says the date and everything like that. So amazing, amazing detail on this piece. I rarely like to take the acrylic off of it just because it is very, very clean in there, but I might do so for a review if it's requested. And then I got the Evo magazine back there that is talking about the 1:1, so I figured that kind of looked good together. And then here is a Frontier Art 118 scale Koenigsegg Agera S. This is model number 90, not limited, but the serial number goes to 3 digits, so I bet they're, you know, limiting it to no more than 999 or so. Very, very good detail on this one as well, so we kind of have the Koenigseggs there. Let me see if I'm forgetting anything. Oh yes, open up the drawers here. Here is a 124 scale Dodge Viper, the newer generation of it. Over here is a 124 scale C6 Corvette. Opening over here. I don't really know what scales these are. These are like the little teeny ones, like the LaFerrari was, like the small blue one. But that's a Porsche Carrera GT, Porsche Boxster, and a 148 scale Subaru BRZ. And then like a little go-kart there. Who knows the scale on that one. So that's pretty much all I got now. I also have a 118 scale C7 Corvette that I gave to my dad because that's his car. But anyway, so that's pretty much the collection I have right now. And in the wish list as of right now, I have obviously two Frontier Art Koenigseggs where the doors do not open. And I'm thinking about getting a Auto Art Koenigsegg 118 scale, a red one, because that would be the one that's, you know, out of its case and on display like these Ferraris, and the doors open on those. And then possibly an Auto Art Pagani Zonda Revolution or whatever, but those are a bit pricey and I don't really know because I already have a couple of Paganis here, even though they're not like on the same kind of quality side of things. But so that's kind of my wish list now. I'm going to keep looking, but as for now, I'm pretty proud of the collection. So again, most of the links I could find, Amazon's pretty much the easiest to find. I'll put all of those links in the description, and if I have any more unboxing, any more cars, I'll definitely keep you guys up to date. But until then, thank you guys for watching, and have a good day.